Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you are new, welcome, thank you for watching. If you are new, remember to hit the subscribe button, give the video a thumbs up, and make sure you hit that notification bell so that you can be notified when new videos are posted. And today again, I am a happy planner newbie, so exciting. And I'm doing the last week of August spread and plan with me kind of thing. And I wanted to show that this week I'm not doing too much washi tape. What I did was I purchased this recollections sheets, and you can see it has different colors and different things in here that you can use. Very pretty, very colorful. I know that the fall is coming and Christmas and things like that, and a lot of spreads will be, you know, themed based or seasonal based. And me, I like lots of color. I like, you know, vibrant colors. So I'm doing this spread like that. And what I did was I picked out a few of the sheets, and they look like this. So I picked out four different ones that I was going to use, and then I used a index card and I cut it down to the size, or closest to the size of the full box, because as you guys know, my first plan with me video, I had asked about Big Happy Planner stickers, like the full box stickers, do they carry those? Because I know every time I go into Michael's and Hobby Lobby or Joann's, I don't ever find the ones that say, or that are big enough to cover it. And I know one of the followers on YouTube told me they do have them. Also my sis Nae Denise also told me to check out Amazon and Me and My Big Ideas. So thank you guys for sharing that. And in place of that, I said, well, you know, I can cut out some sheets of paper and cover the boxes and use those, you know, to just add color and different things to the spread. So that's what I did this week. All I did was cut those out, and again, they looked just like this, and I cut them out, and then I just used glue. You can use double-sided tape, whichever works for you. And I laid them out. Again, I used the orange bordered ones for the ends, and as you can see, as that one, it didn't cut, it was shorter, and I think it was because the way I was trying to get the edges, and so it was a little bit shorter, but I will cover that up. And excuse the oil, my essential oils had spilled and touching the paper, it got on there. So this is what the spread looks like. It has flowers. I did every other one, and then I had some lined, and then I had just the flower edges, and then just some watermarked ones, and then, or tie-dye ones, whichever you want to call it. So that is what the weekly spread looks like. And then I was watching a YouTube video, and I believe it's called Planning with Quita, and she showed how to do trifold, like weekly overview, weekly overview sheet. And you can make it into a trifold, so that way you can use this to do like bulk planning and, you know, more note writing. And then on the weekly spread, you know, you can spread it out how it needs to be. And I thought that was very good, because I do a lot of planning with my Facebook group, Transform Through God's Word. We have Bible studies coming up. September is going to be very busy as we get back in the swing of things. As you guys know from previous videos, my children were here, my oldest two children, and so now they're back home for school. So now I'm able to get back to things, trying to get back in the swing of things, of making more videos of the different planning and things that we're doing. So here I'm going to do the trifold. So what I did here is I used an extra sheet that came in one of the packets that I bought that had like the little folders and stickers and things. So because it has already like the two sections, it's going to be a little bit off, because I don't want it to actually go over all the way to the edge. So I just folded it, and then of course you have like this little overlap here, but it doesn't bother me. I know you can use just like the lined paper and it'll be better probably, but I'm using what I have. And then this is a half sheet from the packet that I have purchased for me and my big ideas. So this one, it comes with all things big ideas, get it done, and notes. And all I did was cut off the edge so that way I can add it here. And you just kind of line it up as much as you want, as close as you can, and then you're going to use washi tape to hold it together. And it's so exciting. My kids, my daughter is in fourth grade, my son is in third grade, and then my youngest son is getting ready to start school soon. So it's exciting seeing everybody grow. So here you're just going to, and you can use a little extra at the top. I'm trying to get it kind of even in the center like that. And you can use, like, you can use this line as kind of a guide. To kind of get your tape as even as possible, like that. And then you're going to flip it over. And if it's off anywhere, then you can readjust the page. And it looks like it's a little bit. Let's see. I'm going to put it all the way off because it was a little off-centered. I like washi tape because it's really, you can easily take things off without it ripping the page. And then you can just flip this part down for extra security on the page. And then you just stretch. I'm not a real perfectionist with everything being so aligned. Doesn't bother me. So again, I am new to happy planning. I'm a normal, you know, I use paper and pen and write everything out, but I was asked to get a happy planner. It would change my life and really enjoy it. So that is what I did. So now you can just fold it. You can see here, and then you're going to fold this other one. Let's see, like that. And so now you have a trifold, and then this will be your front. And I really like this idea because, again, I write a lot, you know, especially with my Facebook group, planning Bible studies and book discussions and things like that. And it just helped keep everything in one place. And I was like, oh, this is awesome. So this is what the trifold looks like. And it'll look a little different if you use just lined paper and things like that. But I thought this was cute. So I'll have that, and then I can decorate this as well. So that was another idea that I got. So let's get back to the weekly spread. So now I'm just going to use some stickers. I did buy some new stickers. Let's see. I got these flower ones because I noticed I have a lot of the productivity stickers, which is this one. I have like three of these, and so I was like, man, I have a lot of like planning stickers, to-do list boxes, things like that, which is good because I like, you know, my planner to be real functional to write in and things like that. And then I got this one, because it had like flowers and things like that that you can add to be more decorative. So again, I'm learning new ways of, or new things. I watch a lot of YouTube videos. So thank you to all the Happy Planner community for sharing your ideas. But I really like this one. So let's find some stickers to, let's see, start decorating. So I know starting off, I want to cover this section right here. And I also got this one, like the seasonal one, which you guys, when I was flipping through, I was like, man, these stickers are a lot bigger than normal. So I'm guessing this one is for the big happy planner, but I don't see where it says like for big, or I guess you just kind of have to look in it. If you guys know, or you guys can share with me, like, does it specifically say on here for big? And you guys, I take it out of the thing and just tie it, and I have it in a box. But I was like, man, these stickers are a lot bigger than normal. So let's see. I want to find a sticker to cover up that spot. I'm so excited, guys. I'm in Washington, and it's been cool weather, like in the 60s. And I'm so loving it. I love the cool weather. And with having lupus, not having so much sunlight, because that's like one of my triggers for flare-ups is the sun and things like that. So I am so loving it. I'm glad that summer is pretty much over. This one doesn't have a sticker that I want. It's more relaxing. So let's see, I'm gonna look back in this one again. I'm looking for a sticker to cover up that section. Let's see, guys. Okay, so these, I'm gonna use this sticker right here. This one is, this came in the little pack that I got with the folders for the Happy Planner, and it just came with two sheets of stickers. So I'm going to use this one that says Hello Weekend, and I'm going to cover this piece up real quick, because that one is the most noticeable, that the cut is different. And you guys, definitely, if you're new to my channel, check out my Facebook group. We're definitely growing every day, every month. We're going to be getting more active into the different Bible studies and verse mapping. We'd love you guys to join in. Let me know what you think. I'm always open to ideas. Again, I said this month we'll be doing more videos and things like that. So the next thing I want to do is I'm going to cover up these oil spaces first. So maybe I'll use out of this sticker book, maybe I'll use a flower just to cover it up. Let's see what we have. Let's see, maybe this one. Make it go. Oops. I don't know if I like that. Okay, so maybe we won't go with this sticker. So maybe we'll go with a box. Because again, this week we have a lot of things going on preparing for September. So I have a lot of things to do between Monday and Friday, actually. We're on Saturday we start our 40-day fast. We start our new scripture writing plan. We're going into chapter 5, the first week of September, of Lady in Waiting that we're reading. We're doing chronological study. One of my new members of my Facebook group, she added me to her group, and it's linked to some more Bible studies. And for September, our theme is praying through the names of God. And one of the Bible studies, it's called Names of God. And it's a 6-week Bible study, so I'm actually thinking of adding that to the schedule for September. I'm not sure yet, but again, I have a lot of things that I'm preparing for. Let's see if we have any color. Let's see, this color kind of, this one goes with it. You see, guys, and this takes me so long to really pick out everything, because me, I would just leave it like that and write a lot of things. So I'm really learning how to use all my stickers and things. Okay, so let's start out with maybe, let's get a to-do list. Because I want to cover up this box right here. So or that oil spill. So I'll do this like this. Let's see, you guys. I don't know if this doesn't look centered. Uh-oh. Let's see. Oh, no. I'm going to mess up the sticker. Okay, so we're going to leave it like that. It looks pretty even. Then, let's see. We'll put maybe a coffee cup here. Because first things first is I'm going to need some coffee in the morning. It is already, I'll put it right here, coffee. It is like almost 2:00 in the morning, guys. Monday morning. And I'm a little bit behind on my planning, which is okay because I write everything down on just regular paper. So let's see. We have a to-do list. And normally here I would, what I'm going to do, and which I'll probably still do, is the blank boxes. I use this thing that I got with the Happy Planner. I don't know if you guys can see that. Let me see if I can put it up against this so you guys can see. And you can do your check boxes here so you can write in your boxes. Or you can leave them blank and write them in also. So many ideas. And let's see. So we're going to have a to-do list there. And here I'm going to put another box. So let's see, I'm gonna use this green one to kind of put the things that are important to get done during the week. So I'll put this here, and you guys can see like these stickers are small, but you can still make them work. So that's always exciting. And so I'm gonna put, and let's see, this orange color. And you guys can see, I'm just using this productivity sticker book. So I'm gonna use this one that says important. And I guess I'm gonna have to get some tweezers. I see a lot of people use tweezers on their YouTube videos. with their planning, and I'm starting to see why, because sometimes these stickers are very hard to get off or to put on. So we'll put right here, important. Like that. So it says important. And then let's see, what else do I need? Let's move this out the way and we'll do through Wednesday first. And then we'll do like maybe a motivational sticker here. So let's go to the faith. And let's see. Oh, I like this one. It says, plant smiles, grow laughter, harvest love. So we'll use that sticker. And I'll put right in the middle. Like that. And then let's see. Now this week I don't have any discussions that we're doing. Everything's going to be pushed until September so that it's all in order. So let's see. What else we have going on here? Now again, on these I put, and so let's do that. These I use this, so I just grab my pen. Oops. And I use just a fine point pen and I line the blue line to it. And I add my boxes or my lines here. So let's see, I'll do it like that. And I start low, or put them low, because up here I put stickers or something at the top. And this just helps me with writing my to-do lists and my group meetings that I have with my leaders in the group, the co-founder of my group. So it's all about growing. And again, that little oil spot is just going to bug me, but it's okay. And then I just extend the line all the way across. And I know there's a stamp actually that you can get to where it has all this already. Okay, so it looks like that. And then I do that for all the empty boxes. Okay guys, so this is what I have so far. So again, I use this stencil to create the check boxes at the bottom, or in the middle and then at the bottom. And then I'm just using stickers from the productivity pack that looks like this. Oh, I'm sorry, the rainbow pack. It's the rainbow pack, this one. And I'm using those stickers to write to do. And again, because this week is a busy busy, busy week for me with making packets for the fast and different evaluations or spiritual inventory and things like that, hindrances, things that we're going to be doing that's going to incorporate with the or go conjoined with the fast and things like that. So I'm super, super excited. So now I'm going to put some more boxes up here at the top. And let's see, I want one that says focus on. So we'll do focus on. Let's see. I'll put it here. Because again, Friday is my deadline for a lot of things. So I'm going to put focus on here. And then what I'm going to do, I've been using sticky notes. So as you guys can see here, I've been using incorporating a lot of sticky notes. I like sticky notes because they're easy to move around if things change. So for my first spread, I'll show you guys that I did the first week that I got my happy planner. So I used washi tape here, and then I did use some sticky notes, but I used a lot of washi tape for the background and things like that. And then I just wrote in a lot of things, and I made the balloons and stuff out of washi tape and added strings. It was my son's birthday. And then here is when I had to take my children back home. So again, a bittersweet day, but you know, school is starting and they'll be back, hopefully for Christmas. So when I came back, I was like, man, I missed, you know, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday of planning, what to do, how am I gonna fix it? And all I did was take the half sheet, the same one that I used for the trifold, this from this pack. I took the half sheet and I cut it down into two parts, and then I used washi tape to box it. And then I used sticky notes, and this was just like for emails that I needed to send, notes to take and stuff like that. So I added here, and then I used stickers to cover up the date, which I thought was really, you know, functional, again, because you guys are all about a functional planner. And then here too, I put, you know, PDF files that I'm working on for the book club, for my chronological study, things like that, the calendar and stuff for the group. So I love using sticky notes also. So that's something new for me that I'm adding to planning. So that's probably what I'll use here, or maybe a quote to add. And you guys definitely can tell me what you think, any ideas. Again, I'm going to start trying to do videos on every week to kind of just show my planning for the week and just try to make it a habit. I'm definitely trying to get more into this happy planner thing. It's very, very fun, you guys. Very fun. So if you don't have one, definitely grab one. I will be showing me setting up for September, the monthly spread, but I also wanted to kind of do this one with you guys just to kind of show you my progress. So let's see, I need something, let's see, maybe I'll do an exclamation point here just to signify that it's important to get those done. And then I can leave that little space open. Let's see, maybe we can find a little sticker. Okay, so here, we'll use this one. It says top priority. Because for again, Friday is my deadline for a lot of things that I need to have done. And then we'll use at the bottom to kind of pull out this yellow. I'll put here, don't forget. And then on this side, I'll put note to self. Like that. And then let's see, for Thursday, I have a lot of, Thursday. This is cute. I like this sticker. It says time to get to work. So I'll put that right here just as a quote as we wind down to the end. And let's see. And then I'm going to use this today's focus in this one. Well, let's see, maybe I'll put it, no, I don't want it. Oh, maybe I'll put it here, today's focus. And you guys, normally I write along the sides of things. So I think that's pretty much it that I'm going to put on this spread. Let's see. Yeah, I think that's it. I think that's all I'm going to put on this spread, so that way I have a lot of functional space. Again, I use sticky notes. So that's probably what I'll be putting here, is a sticky note. And I use the sticky notes for like emails or blog, not blog posts, but Facebook posts that I get. That I need to respond to. So I'll probably just put these here. And I think that's really it, guys. Maybe add some flowers or something. This one's cute. Put a flower there. Maybe. Put it here, two-sided like that. Oops. I guess this is what being a planner newbie takes, a lot longer. And let's see, maybe just one more flower. Maybe yes, the two. the two small ones. I'll put here. And not this one. Let's see, we have this one that matches that bottom one. Pretty cute. I can add an extra flower just to add to it, the pink. Okay, that looks cute. Looks done. Let's see, maybe I like this one. Let's see, it says enjoy every day. I want a little sticker right here. So let's see. Oh, I like this one, so I'll put this one there. So that one says happy day, and I'll add it right here on this part and kind of let it overlap just like that. And it has some little matching hearts. Just like that. All right, I think I'm done, guys, with this week's spread. All the blank spaces I will just write in pen. Let me know what you think. I will utilize this. And you see, guys, it's getting oil. I have to see where the oil is. So that's the only disadvantage of having an essential oil burner. I'll be utilizing this, so maybe I'm not sure if I'm going to use it for this week or if I'm going to use it starting for the first, but if I definitely use it, I will show you guys that in another video. But this is what the week spread looks like. I hope you like it. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, leave them below and I will reply to them. If you would like to join in on our 40-day fast starting on the 1st, leave me your email address and I can send you the packet or anything pertaining to the studies that you see on my Facebook channel. Every month we do verse mapping and word studies that have packets to go with it, doing book clubs. So always, always, never hesitate to reach out. So you guys have a blessed, blessed day. Bye.